Welcome back, guys. Chris here, and in this video, we're going to be talking about the Business Technology Platform, better known as BTP. And to introduce this subject, we're going to jump to a graphic that I've shown a few times now. And this is an SAP graphic that tries to explain the SAP ecosystem and how these products relate to each other. And as I've said in my earlier videos, because remember, this is not a standalone video, this is all part of my introduction to SAP series. So if you haven't seen those earlier videos, I highly recommend you check them out. But what I've covered before is we've got our core ERP, you can see that is cloud ERP here on this graphic. You can also see the other products that are attached to that by business sector. And then that's sitting on top of the business data cloud. We can even see the Joule element, which I'll talk more about in the following video. But we've got all of these different things, this rainbow, that's all sitting on what you may not have noticed, which is the business technology platform at the bottom. So this really gets that concept across that everything that we're talking about, all of these various products, they're all lying on top of this platform. And that's really the best way to think about it. Without getting too technical, the BTP is what allows everything to integrate in with each other. So you might have thought, you know, coming into this that you've got a product like Concur, and Concur will communicate with S/4HANA and then back to Concur. What's actually happening is that Concur is communicating to BTP, which is then communicating to S/4HANA, and on between all the different products. So it brings these things together. It's like the glue that's holding this entire system all integrated into one structure. So that BTP layer is incredibly important. And this is also in contrast to a lot of other ERP products. If you look at something like Acumatica or Sage or Oracle NetSuite, you've got one ERP product. And if you want to try to attach other products onto that, what you need to do is have a full-fledged integration. Oftentimes you need to pay for a separate connector like Soligo so that you can get the information from one product to your main ERP and then back if necessary. So there's a lot of different things that go involved in that. And there's an implementation timeline. Depending on what you're integrating, it might be a week. It could be up to a month or more, depending on the complexity of it. When you're dealing with BTP, let's say you've got S/4HANA in the middle of your system and you want to start bringing in Ariba and SuccessFactors or Taulia, it is very simple in BTP to just turn these things on and immediately connect them. You don't have to go through a lengthy implementation. There's not some major additional expense to get a connector that's going to bring these two things together. It's all facilitated by BTP. So that is a core element of this whole cloud infrastructure and the ecosystem. And when we talk about BTP, there's really five elements to it. And I want to run through those in order, starting with the first one, which I've really just described, and that is the integration element. That is obviously a major aspect of BTP. But then you get to the second element, which is the application development. So BTP facilitates and has basically a tool set that allows for additional app and product development. So for example, you can use SAP Build. That's a tool that will allow you to do low or even no code app development within BTP in that ecosystem. But there's also other environments, and you could call them runtime environments, that you can utilize. Things like Cloud Foundry, you also have CAP, there's Kima Runtime. Each one of these can be utilized, not necessarily that you have to use all of them, but you can use whichever one is going to facilitate your needs for app development. And there's not one programming language that you're going to be stuck with. When you're dealing with BTP, there's a lot of flexibility that is allowed within that. So you can use programming languages like ABAP, Java, SAP UI5, you can use Node.js, there's even Rust. There's so many different programming languages that each will fit within their own development environment that you can utilize when dealing with SAP products. And all of that is facilitated by BTP. So that is the second core element of the system. You then have the third element, which is the fact that you can create business automations. So there are many SAP products individually that have their own automation tool or often a workflow tool. So for example, S/4HANA has a workflow tool, SuccessFactors does. But then when you step out to a platform level with BTP, you can create automations that work in between products. And the automations don't have to just be workflows. You can also set up agent automations that basically you can give it tasks to, like closing out or reconciling the bank at the end of the month. There's specific things that you can organize that it can then run those on autopilot at a platform level, not just in one product, but connecting amongst multiple products. Then we get to the fourth element, which is data and analytics. So like we talked about in the last video, we've got business data cloud, and just like everything else, that is sitting on top of BTP. So BTP facilitates and allows for that massive aggregation of data and the ability to then pull that out as analytical reports, insights, dashboards, etc. And then lastly, we get to the fifth element, which we really haven't talked about much in this series, and that is the AI element. So we'll get into Joule in the following video, but just to very briefly explain it, Joule is really, it's not one product, it's many different products. It's all kind of that category or the umbrella of these AI tools. Oftentimes we're looking at agentic AI tools to utilize not just in one SAP product, but they can be utilized in multiple products. And SAP is definitely moving in the direction of having AI capabilities in all of their products. So all of those are facilitated. Again, if you think about a product as something that's sitting on top of BTP, and then another AI element is going to be coming on top of that, that connection between these things and the ability for Joule to work between apps and products is again allowed by having that BTP layer in the first place. So that should give you a concept, and I'll list them out here again, just of the five major areas that BTP facilitates by having a platform like that. Now, in terms of how we came to have BTP, originally there was HANA Cloud Platform. That was about a decade ago. That became SAP Cloud Platform. There was also a product in 2017 called SAP Leonardo, and there was elements of that product, although you could consider that was a failed project. There's elements of that that then got incorporated along with the work that had been done on the cloud platform and all brought together as BTP. And that came out in 2021, which was a much more comprehensive and extensive platform to facilitate all of these things, as opposed to just focusing on one or two of the five elements that I described earlier. So that's just a quick historical look at how we came to have BTP. The last thing I want to talk about in this video is the subject of ABAP, which I've referenced a little bit earlier on in this video and some of the earlier videos in this series. ABAP is a programming language that was created by SAP. And the reason I want to talk about it is because you're going to hear it come up. There's probably more YouTube videos on the subject of ABAP than everything else combined on the subject of SAP. So when it comes to ABAP, and I'm talking to non-developers, because obviously if you're a programmer, you probably are already aware of this. ABAP is the programming language that was used for the older ERP systems predominantly. So if we're looking at something like the precursor to S/4HANA, which was ERP Central Component, also known as ECC, that was the programming. If you wanted to go in and you wanted to start doing customizations for that, you used ABAP to accomplish that. So it was definitely a very widely used programming language. And even with S/4HANA, you can use ABAP to customize S/4HANA, as long as you're not doing it on the public cloud for S/4HANA. Now, if you don't know what any of that means, it's totally fine. In the very next video, we're going to be taking an overview look at the public cloud versus the private cloud, rise versus grow. What do these things mean? We're going to be going through all of that. I just wanted to have a quick recap and make sure that you understood what ABAP was and how that fits in with BTP at a platform level, and how way down the spectrum you've got ABAP, which is used for customizations and developing and handling the code at an ERP level for SAP. So on that note, if this video was helpful for you, please hit that like button and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. I have to complete this introductory SAP series, and then on the heels of that, I'll be coming out with more full-fledged videos and courses on diving into specific SAP products. So if any of that's interesting to you, by all means, stay tuned. And with that in mind, I hope to see you in the next video.